acting debut? Was it nerve-wracking?
I wanted to be like a complete artist, and I want to be a pop star, and my journey in acting has started, which will parallelly go with music.
And if I could ask you about the messaging of the movie?
We have to have our life in our own hands. I cannot stand anybody else take decisions for me.
You're real with Farah also. Both of you have been keeping track of what exactly is happening online.
She really felt bad with what happened, and I think during the promotion of the film, she said that, you know what, I'd be very happy to do this, and we just cleared the air. And anyway, there was no bad blood between us. I really love her. I think she's fab.
So hi everyone, thank you for watching Spill the Beans on CNN News 18. Present with me is the cutest Dhwani Bhanushali. Thank you so much for speaking to us, Dhwani. How are you?
I'm good. How are you? It's been great.
I am good too. Well, we all saw कहाँ शुरू कहाँ खत्म. तो चलिए चलिए आपसे उसी के बारे में सबसे पहले पूछते हैं. How was it? It was your acting debut. Was it nerve wracking?
It was actually. It was like I was very excited also, but along with being nervous, because you know I believe like there has to be excitement when you start a new journey, and I always wanted to sort of have this feather in my cap. Contributing the idea of being a complete artist, and very happy that my debut is now out and people have loved it so much. I got a lot of appreciation for my character, and I'm just thrilled that I've started this journey and added to the fact that I wanted to be like a complete artist, and I want to be a pop star, and my journey in acting has started, which will parallelly go with music. So it's quite a thrilling experience.
And since you have talked about, you know, being an artist, a pop artist, that too, especially, we have seen, thank you God also, we have seen you dancing. But when did you exactly get that knack for acting in front of the camera for a whole long feature movie?
Knack of, I don't know when that sort of seed happened, but it was just along the way while I was doing music, you know, I just felt like I had to explore explore acting or just like, you know, just sort of do workshops and sort of understand the art. Little did I know while I was doing the training that something like this will sort of happen in my life, and I'll get to do my debut film, because you know these days it's so hard to sort of put yourself in the theaters. But that really happened for me, and I'm at this point I just pinch myself and I'm like, great.
So was it challenging for you? How challenging was the acting part in front of the cameras? Also, I want to ask you, was there any specific point in the movie where you had to take a lot of recuts, you know, that this is something that I really want to get correct and it's extremely difficult?
You know, I just believe that I had so much focus on who Meera was. And I was so aligned with my director on everything. We'd actually rehearsed all the scenes beforehand, but he also gave me this liberty to flow being her. And but of course it was very challenging. I did do two workshops for the same, and it's always challenging to face a camera being someone else, because I've done my music and I've been in my videos, I've been myself, I've been shades of myself, but I've never been someone else. And to constantly keep that thought in mind, her story and her struggles and her happiness and the way she is, it just, to imbibe all of that and to keep with it was challenging. And I also had great guidance in terms of Lakshman sir and Saurabh. So every time they'd feel that I'm going a little bit out of character, they would obviously point it out. And but yeah, man, it's a very different sort of journey that one takes when they want to become an actor and when they want to play a character. I feel like a lot of, you constantly have to be present and you constantly have to be in the moment of the scene and to do well, because there are also cuts, right? But you have to deliver similarly so that they can match it.
Yeah.
When they do a certain scene,
The
so
post
that's,
is smooth,
yeah, no, not the post. Even like as an actor, when you have to perform it again and again, and in the same sort of mood, or I can't explain it right now, but I feel like you have to constantly keep performing it again and again and again, and you have to be in the same space. And I feel like that does get challenging for someone, because it's also energy at the end of the day, and it can get drained. And there's a human aspect that also comes into the picture. It can get quite daunting, but I'm just really happy that I had my focus really 100% on with like blinders and just went for it.
And if I could ask you about the messaging of the movie, because it's very crucial at this point of time in our country that you're talking about, seeking consent. And this is a very message that could be given out to all the feminists also, that you should not be giving up your peace. At this point of time, why do you think doing Kahan Shuru Kahan Khatam was extremely important for you as somebody who is a female, who is an ambitious woman, who is a working lady?
It's very important. Yeah, I think it's very important for all of us women and girls to sort of know that we have to have our life in our own hands. I cannot stand anybody else take decisions for me. And I'm sure even you wouldn't. I mean, at any level of life, yeah, I just feel whether you're working or not, it's basic to have your life in your own hands and to have decisions that you take over somebody else just laying it out for you. And that's why I also resonated with Meera's character also, was this reason, this very reason. And we've shown it as an example that she runs away because her dad doesn't ask her who she wants to marry, whether she wants to get married or no. But it happens in so many other things that we go through on a daily basis, right? Who really asks? Like, I sometimes feel like there are so many women who are not given free will. And it was for them. And sometimes unknowingly, even you and I, unless we put our foot down, nothing really, people just assume that they can take decisions for us. So I feel like it's a very big point to raise, and they were doing this through the film, and I just thought that I have to be a part of something like this, to say that. And I don't understand this word feminist. I feel like everybody, it has to be a normal thing. It can't, it you can't put a term to it. People have to, the society now has to be at a place where they think that, oh bro, a woman is a person. She has the right to sort of take her own decisions, to live her life, to have free will. And of course, when that happens, we also know and aware, high on our emotional quotient, that we will not go out of our, we will not rebel. If everything is happening the way we want, in the, that is happening around us, that keeps us happy and not caged, why would we do a certain thing? Why would we run away? Or why would we say anything that is upsetting to a certain group of people? We would not. We would live our lives properly, freely, happily. So it's just that it's a very simple thing. You just need to sort of have
But why
let
should there be any need of a movie to tell you what is right and what is wrong? Very interesting.
yeah.
But Dani, let's circle back to your journey as a singer, since we have already spoken about how you are a thriving pop artist in our culture, and this is something that people have started giving a term to, that this is extreme westernization of the music of India. People say that India was a country with music that had folk and classical in the picture, but singers like you have shown us that we can have something which is very different to what a picture we had about the music and art in our country. If I could ask you, what do you think about people naming it as westernization of music?
Westernization of music. I feel like while I have a lot of respect for classical, I also, I'm still studying it with my Guruji, and but this is some sort, it's a different expression that you could call it modernization, but that's where the world is going. I mean, yeah, people want different sounds, people want songs that are modern, and I feel like we're catering to that supply. And you and I are young people. We've grown up also listening to the West a lot, and it's just there's no disrespect to any genre. It's just that things are evolving, and there is a market full of youngsters that wants to listen to music that is what we're making, and they want beats, they want a certain kind of song, and if I feel like that's happening, why not? Because I don't understand why it shouldn't happen. Because you need music to evolve. You can't be just doing classical and just sticking to a genre. Of course, that's brilliant. It's amazing to sort of have that. But I am not against the music that we do. I think it takes a lot of effort to make it, and people in the West are doing it for years and years and years and years. And if we're influenced, there's no problem with it at all.
And if I could ask you about the kind of projects that you have done, because you have given us some of the really great bangers. Which song actually came to your life as your life-changing project?
I think Vasudev was something that happened to me that was life-changing, because I really feel like people, the whole demographic, started to know who I am, and they really started to. I was this innocent little kid with this song, love song, and people really liked it, and I feel like it really opened doors for me to sort of explore a career in music.
And I remember we all had our ringtone set with Vaste. I was in college, your song came, and
I
we all used to that song on loop. Last but
was
not the least, because I have been looking through a lot of reels that you have been sharing when the movie proportions came into the picture, and I saw your reel with Farah also. You have sort of shut down every troll out there that, there was a moment that happened, but excuse me, I
Yeah.
can actually turn it into something very heartwarming. How did that
Yeah.
happen? Both of you have been keeping track of what exactly is happening online.
No, I feel like Farah ma'am is really sweet, and she just, even when that happened, I think I wouldn't have an excuse for it, but I was just really sick, and people also had twisted the sort of audio and sort of added a different tuner to it and then put it up. And anyway, that's a very different conversation, but I feel like at the end of the day, we all work very hard as artists to sort of have a mark, and for people to sort of know us for what we are. And it's daily work, and I just feel like she really felt bad with what happened. And I think during the promotion of the film, she said that, you know what, I'd be very happy to do this, and we just cleared the air. And anyway, there was no bad blood between us. I really love her. I think she's fab. There was nothing,
That's
there was no absolute stress at all. It was nobody's fault.
that's really cute. I know I said that was the last question, but I would really love to know any scoop on what exactly are you working on next.
I'm going to release a single very soon, because like I said, I am a musician, and at the end of the day, you so I'm gonna do films and then music and then films and then music. So it's gonna be like a constant parallel process. And I think I'm at this point very blessed to say that next one is a single.